Today, I'm going to show you three different text animations or typography animations using the motion trails effect. These animations are very interesting and easy to create in DaVinci Resolve, especially the last one. I am Vikas Kumar from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's create a new project and get started. Alright, so this is the DaVinci Resolve 18.6 edit page, and all you have to do the basic setting first. So click on the setting button in the corner and set the size of this project 1920 by 1080, which is a full HD resolution. You can create this animation in 4K resolution as well. You can select a 4K preset from here, which is the Ultra HD. And now let's select a frame rate. So in this case, I am using 24 frames per second, which is good enough, and click on save. Now let me show you how you can create this animation inside of the Fusion page. So first of all, we have to take a new Fusion composition. It's very simple. Just go to media pool, right click on that and create a new Fusion composition from here. And you can call it text 01, because this is gonna be the first text. You can set the duration 5 seconds long, frame rate 24, and then click on create. Once done, let's drag and drop the Fusion composition on the timeline and then just go to the Fusion page. Here we have the media out node, so just drag this media out to the side for now. We will use this media out at the end of this animation. Now let's start by creating a text node. So this is the text. Let's drag and drop on the flow window, and now let's take a preview of the text. So just drag and drop the text to the viewer to get a preview, and here we have to type anything, whatever you like. And then you can select your favorite font style. So in this case, I'm using Gotham Ultra. So this is the Gotham Ultra font style. You can select any font style that you like. You can increase the size of the text. So I'm going to set the value 0.2. Perfect. Now we need to animate the text. It's very simple. You can animate any parameter of the text node. Let's go to the layout. Here we have the Z rotation. I'm going to animate the Z rotation. So just go to very first frame of this animation. Right click on Z rotation. Click on animate. Or you can also click on the diamond button to create a keyframe. And then just go to the end of this animation. Let's set the Z rotation value 360. Now we have 360 rotation, as you can see. But this animation is linear right now, so we have to make it smoother and interesting. So what we have to do, just go to spline window, hit F4 on the keyboard to full screen, check this text 1. Here we have both the keyframes, so highlight both the keyframe, click on fit button, hit S on the keyboard to make it smoother, or you can also click on this smooth button. Perfect. Now let's make an interesting curve. So just go to frame number 40, hold this handle and place the handle right over here. Go to frame number 90 or maybe 80 and hold this first handle and place it right over here. Now you can see the result. Perfect. And then just close the spline window. After that, we have to create a motion trail effect. So it's very simple. Select the text node, hit Ctrl plus a spacebar for search box and search for motion trail. So this is the motion trail. Select that node, hit add button, drag the motion trail to the viewer. Here we have to do some settings. So just go to inspector window. Here we have trail length. Let's increase the value. You can set the value 30. Perfect. And you can adjust this value according to you. You can adjust the drop off value as well. You can see the result here. So I'm going to set the value 0.8. Now open the move trail, and here we have the soften. Let's set the value 0.5. Perfect. So here we have the motion trail effect. Now I'm going to merge this motion trail effect with the original text. So what we have to do, let's take a new merge node. I'm going to use this text output as a background and this motion trail output as a foreground. So here we have the background and the foreground point. I'm going to connect the yellow background point with the output of this text node and green foreground point with the output of this motion trail. And now let's drag and drop the merge one to the viewer. And after that, we have to blend foreground and the background. So select the merge, go to inspector window and change this apply mode normal to screen. Perfect. And now let's colorize this motion trail effect. So this is the color corrector node. You can connect the color corrector with this merge. Drag and drop the color corrector one to the viewer. You can select any color from here, just like that. And I want to create gradient kind of color. So we have to create two different color. you can take one more color corrector node, connect the output of this merge one with this second color corrector, drag and drop to the viewer to get a preview, and here you can select any different color like this. And after that we have to blend both the colors, so it's very simple again. Connect the output of this color corrector one with the second one and you can get a new merge. Drag and drop the merge to the viewer. We have to create a mask, so this is the rectangle. Let's attach the rectangle with the merge node. You can adjust the rectangle like this. Perfect. Now you can increase the soft edge value. You can set the value 0.2. You will get this type of result. And after that we have to create glow effect on it. So select the merge tool, hit Ctrl plus a spacebar for search box and search for glow node. This is the glow. Hit add button, drag and drop the glow to the viewer. Here you can adjust these values. So this is the glow size. Let's increase the glow size just a little bit. So I'm going to set the value 20. And this is the glow. Let's down the glow value and set the value 0.6. Perfect. And now we have the glow effect on this motion trail effect. And after that we have to create motion blur. So hit Ctrl plus a spacebar for search box and search for motion blur. So this is the motion blur node. Select that node, hit add button, drag and drop this motion blur to the viewer, and now it's almost done. So connect the motion blur with this media out and then go to the edit page, and here we have our first motion trail effect, which is looking like this. So this is the circular one. And now let's create the another motion trail effect, which is very simple. So first of all, we have to duplicate this fusion composition. You can hit Ctrl C on the keyboard to copy. Place the CTI right over here, hit Ctrl V to paste. Place the CTI on the second one and then go to the fusion page. First of all, we have to remove the circular text animation. So select the text, go to layout. Here we have the Z rotation. Right click on the Z rotation, click on remove. You can click on this little button to set it default value. As you can see, we don't have any animation. So let's animate the text. Just go to frame number 40, go to center and right click on that, click on animate, go to very first frame of this animation, lock the position as it is. So click on this diamond button right over here and then just go to frame number 40 and you can place the text right over here in upper direction, and then just go to frame number 80. Let's set it right over here. And then just go to the end of this animation, and again you can keep the text in the center, so you can set the value 0.5. perfect. So basically we have this type of text animation. Let's make it smoother. Just go to spline window, hit F4, check the text one, click on fit button, highlight all the keyframes, hit S to smooth, highlight these handle and place the handle right over here and create a smooth graph just like that. Highlight this one, hold this handle and place it right over here. Perfect. Highlight this point and place it over here maybe. So basically we have to create this type of smooth graph. Now you can get this type of smooth motion. Perfect. Now you can close the spline window and you can change the color as well. So you can select any color that you like and you can change the text as well. Just like that. And then you can go to the edit page and here we have the second motion trail effect. Now let me show you another variation. So simply you can duplicate this fusion composition like this. Place the CTI on it, go to fusion composition. First of all you can change the text. Perfect. Now you can change the color and then you can change some parameters and you can create a different variation. So select the motion trail, in this case open the advanced option and here we have the zoom and rotate. You can set the rotation value 2 maybe. As you can see, it's looking very interesting. Now you can adjust the zoom as well, so you can down the zoom value or increase the zoom value to get a different type of result. So in this case I want to set this value 0.98 maybe. Perfect. You can also change the text animation, but this is looking good. Now let's go to the edit page and here we have the third variation of the motion trail effect. Now let's go to very first frame of this animation, turn on the look button, hit Ctrl F to full screen and let's have a look. Absolutely amazing, right? And that's a wrap for this tutorial. If you have any questions or thoughts, feel free to drop a comment below. And if you are new to my channel, consider subscribing and giving this video a thumbs up. My name is Vikas Kumar and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye-bye.